Now let's open back up the modeler. Great. And let's maybe make this full window. So after this point here, prepare for departure, I know that I've got a variable deciding where we want to go, but right now we only have the one option, which is the taxi. So I want to add a gateway. So I'm going to use the, there we go, a nice little make space tool, and I'm going to place a gateway right in the middle here. So this is an XOR gateway. So this will go one of many directions. We're going to have two options. We are going to have another way here, which is going to be book a place on a ship. We also need to decide what the gateway is actually trying to assess. And in this case, it is, where are you going? And we have two options, as you know. We have America, and we also have here France. Okay, right after we do one of these, irrelevant of how we get there, we still want to overthrow the monarchy. So I'm going to use a second gateway to merge the flows back into one again, like so. Okay, so now we have a really simple thing where we have our model that says we will arrive here, we will do either France, get a taxi, or America, book a ship, and then eventually, in both ways, overthrow the monarchy. Now, an interesting thing we need to do here is we have just written this down. We need to actually add some execution semantics. As you may remember, the variable that is created here is called country. So this will either contain the value America or France. So we can use that information to decide where to go. So if I select the sequence flow France, you can see that it has a condition type option. You can use a script for quite complex conditions. In our case, we can use an expression just to decide on what's going on. And the specific expression we're going to use is, we're going to use hash, open curly bracket, country, double equals, and then France. So the reason we're doing that is because we want to be able to see that if someone has selected France, we will go in this direction. The next option is America, of course. So let me select this sequence flow, once again, expression, and then we will paste the sequence flow in there. Now, this book ship task, we've done a lot of user tasks already. So let's do some automation. That's what kind of processes are all about. So I'm going to select a service task here. And this means that I'm going to be able to call a Java class of some kind and run some code. So getting a taxi I can do manually myself, but booking a ship is a little more work, so maybe I'll just automate that in some way. So next we're actually going to create a Java class and then call it here. So let's see how that looks. Okay, so I'm going to minimize this window now and go back to IntelliJ. Now, as I said, we're here to create a Java class. So I'm going to go to the same package that the application class is in. I'm going to right click and select new Java class. The name is going to be reserve seat on boat, because that's what we need to do. Once it's created, we then need to do one very important thing, which is we need to say implements Java delegate. So with Camunda, we want to be able to, we need to always implement a Java delegate class in order to call it from the engine. This is really helpful because it means that we can get the context from the engine within our class. And I'll show you what that means. This does have one requirement here. It needs a method called execute, which takes a variable called delegate execution. As I said, this is a really important method because this allows us to get context from the engine in runtime and be able to decide on what to do accordingly. We can get variables and set variables. So I'm going to copy some code and put it right in here. But basically, if you had any kind of code that is your business logic, it would go right in here. So let me talk through what I've just added. Just a reminder, if you want to copy this code for yourself, the link to the full project is below, so you can go and find this class on GitHub and then take a look at what I've just done. So we have the money, which is 0.0. We have a variable called ticket, which is coach, which is our default ticket type. Now, here's where things get interesting. We are going to ask the execution to get a variable called money. Now, you may remember that this variable was already added by the initial starting point of the process. So we get that money. We then convert it into a double, and then we check if we have lots of money, over 10,000, we get a first class ticket. If it is, let's say, over 5,000, then we get a business class ticket. Otherwise, the default is coach. So at the end, we then tell the execution to set the variable back to instance with the variable name ticket type. What this means is the process will continue with a variable called ticket type with the value that we've added. The last part I want to do is add a named annotation here, because I want to be able to call this bean by name, and I'll show you what that means. If I use named, it means that I can call it with the name of the class without needing to use the package name, which is really handy for doing all sorts of refactoring and things. So let's do that right now. I'm going to copy the name of the class. I'm going to reopen up my modeler here. And again, I have the book, place, and ship selected. And then going to implementation type, we have a few different options. If I set a Java class, I would need to add the full package name. We don't want to do that. We're going to use delegate expression. Now, what does this mean? It means that we're going to write an expression that is going to resolve to the bean in question by the name. So I copied the name of the class. There's one important thing to do is I need to change the case of the first letter. It needs to be lowercase by default. Okay, so this means that when we start this process, it should be able to call this Java class, and when we get back to overthrow the monarchy, we'll then be able to see the ticket type as a variable that's chosen if we have gone via America. So let's do that next. Returning now to my IDE, I'm going to actually stop my running application, and I'm going to just restart it. So this would act as a way of redeploying the process. And also, you may notice an interesting thing, which is this file showed up when I started the first time. This is actually the H2 database that is used. So all the information that was used in the startup initially was created here, which means the startup the second time around will be a little quicker. It'll also have all the data we left there before. So we'll also get to find out what happens when we change the process model and then restart the engine. And it'll be fun. So I'm going to open up my web browser again. I'm going to refresh this. And has it started? Let me just, yep, it has, great. Almost. See, I needed to wait for the start to acquire jobs thing at the bottom. That's how you know it started. So I'm not even taking my own advice. We're back here again. We need to log in as demo. Marvelous. We then have our tasks, zero filters. And then if I go to cockpit, I'll be able to take a look at their processes. And if I click on Lafayette, we have the new process with America as part of it. We still have process one, so the original version. The nice thing is you can still start processes on the older version, but by default, we're going to always start in the latest version of the process. In this case, we're going to select Lafayette, click start. And then just like last time, we have a similar prepare for departure file. I'm going to claim, I'm going to add, let's say some money, let's say same as before. And I'm going to head to America this time. Hopefully this means I'll get a trip on a boat, click complete, and we've gone straight through to overthrow the monarchy. So what I would expect is I select this. You may remember we don't have we didn't implement any front end for this particular task, which means after I claim it, I'll be able to load all the variables. And as you can see, we now have our first class ticket. This happened, of course, because if we go back to cockpit, we actually traveled, let me refresh this page. We started our process right here and prepare for departure. We then went up to America. We ran this Java class, which assessed how much money we had and gave us the corresponding ticket. And then we went down here to overthrow the monarchy, which is wonderful. So we're sitting here for a while because overthrowing the monarchy takes some time. So why not add something we can do while we're overthrowing the monarchy? Now, while Lafayette was in America, he famously wrote back home to his wife occasionally. So let's actually try to implement this. This is something that's quite different because we want to do it in parallel to being able to do this user task. So for that, I'm going to add some new BPMN models and show you how you can combine parallel executions in the same model. Let's do that right now.